Hello everyone. Today, we're going to learn something about how to get job in airlines industry. Myself, Anjali Tomar, HR Manager at Air Crews Aviation Private Limited. Airlines require workers for a multitude of diverse positions. So, it's very likely that you'll be able to find a job in this field. Because of the wide variety of jobs and airlines, the hiring process and job requirements will eventually differ. There are, however, a few elements that will remain pretty consistent in your search for an airline job. Meeting the requirements. First, get the proper education. There are a huge number of jobs in the airline business, all of which require different educational and training. The level of education you will need will depend on which position you are looking for. Below are some of the common airline jobs and the level of education that is required. First is flight attendant. Being a flight attendant typically only requires a high school diploma. If you didn't finish high school, a GED is also an acceptable level of education. Second, air traffic controller. This job requires either a bachelor's degree or at least 3 years of responsible work experience. Any work experience is typically applicable as long as you can demonstrate that you performed completely. After that, you will enter the FAA Academy for education on air traffic controlling. Third is technicians. There are a variety of technicians who work for airlines with different specialties. These jobs usually require at least a bachelor's degree in engineering or even a related field and might require further postgraduate work. You'll also have to pass a certification test to get a job with an airline. Fourth is pilots. Pilots need extensive education and training as well. You will need at least a bachelor's degree to be eligible for the job. Of course, you will need to know how to fly a plane. So it would help you if you already have a pilot's license before starting college. Second is meeting the physical requirements. Some airline jobs have physical requirements as well. These are to ensure that planes are operated safely. First is vision requirements. Pilots, flight attendants, and air traffic controllers must have a 20/20 vision or have corrective eyewear that brings their vision to 20/20. Height and weight requirements. Flight attendants typically must have to be between 5 and 6'3", but this varies between airlines. There is no weight requirement as such, but they must be able to easily walk up and down the aisles of the aircraft. Strength requirements. Flight attendants will probably have to lift bags into overhead cabins. As such, some airlines set strength requirements. Being able to lift around 70 pounds is a typical requirement. Language requirements. Most airline positions require you to speak and read English proficiently. Citizenship. All airlines jobs in the US require you to be able to show proof of being able to work in the US. Medical requirements. Most airline jobs will require you to pass a medical exam to make sure you are healthy enough to perform your job. Pilots typically have to be examined every 6 months in order to ensure that they are capable of operating a plane. Age requirements. Most airline jobs will require you to be able to be at least 18. If your job requires you to attend the FAA Academy, you must enroll before you turn 31. Pass a security test. Like most employers, airlines will conduct a background check on applicants. This will typically be more extensive than a normal background check. There are a number of offenses that could cause concern for airlines. Browse job postings for airline jobs. You'll be able to locate all kinds of airline jobs on the internet. There are numerous ways you can find them. If you want to work for a particular airline, try checking that airline's website. There will usually be a job employment or career opportunities tab. If you can't find anything on the homepage, try typing in the airline's name and jobs into an internet search engine. Jobs are posted on more general sites, so browse these sites as well. Contact airlines directly. If you are not finding any jobs browsing the internet, you could try contacting airlines directly. Sometimes there are job openings that are not posted yet. If you are lucky, you might come across some of these by inquiring with airlines. Try either calling or maybe emailing the human resources department of specific airlines and inquiring about job openings. Put your resume and cover letter together. Whenever you are applying for a job, you will need a resume and cover letter. In many ways, preparing those documents for an airline position is just preparing one for any other job. There are a few things you might want to emphasize, however, depending on the job you are looking for. First, read, write a cover letter, and make a resume for general tips on preparing your resume and cover letter. For a flight attendant position, you will want to emphasize any customer service experience you have had. Flight attendants spend most of their time helping passengers. So, any experience you have working with the general public will be valuable. For any kind of technical position, you will want to emphasize jobs and internships you have had that required electrical or engineering skills. Always read job ads carefully. For example, it's common for postings to look for highly motivated candidates. In this case, explain in your letter how you are highly motivated. This shows that you have been taken the time to read the posting and put together a good cover letter. Basically, use phrases and words from the job posting to demonstrate why you are a good candidate. Prepare for the interview. If you have done a good job on your cover letter and resume, you will progress to the interview stage of the job. The particular interview process will vary depending on which job you are looking for. A flight attendant may get the job after only a quick meeting, while a pilot will probably require several interviews and tests. Conduct yourself appropriately during the interview. No matter what position you are applying for, you should always maintain polite and professional demeanor during a job interview. Many positions in an airline, like a pilot, technician, or air traffic controller, are directly responsible for people's safety. Accordingly, interviewers will want to hire competent and serious individuals for jobs. Always remember to dress appropriately for the interview. Many airline positions, including flight attendants and pilots, will require you to interact with airline customers. There really is no way to anticipate the type of questions you will get during an interview. Generally, you should be prepared to talk about your strengths and have a few stories ready to tell that demonstrate your competence and or responsibility. What are the jobs available in airline industry? Airline jobs. On Airline Job Finder, we break down many different kinds of airline careers. Each of the following types of airline jobs is discussed in great detail in a free member section. Flight attendant jobs. The main responsibility of a flight attendant is to make sure passengers are safe. Next, they must provide great customer service. Airline administrative support. Every airline, big and small, needs administrative support staff to keep the office running smoothly. And those who work in the human resources department, who handle or oversee the hiring, labor relations issues, training, and termination of the employees. Operations agent. Also known as an airline operations agent, the cargo agent needs great communication skills for receiving and transmitting information from and to pilots. Avionics technicians. Avionics technicians specialize in working on the electronic system of aircraft. Calibration of the equipment may also be required. Regional sales manager. The airline district sales manager oversees all of a district's reservations and ticket sales offices. Flight dispatcher. Flight dispatchers are responsible for ensuring the safety of an aircraft's flight. Ground or airport station attendant. This position has many names: airline informational representative, ground attendant, or airport informational representative. Regardless of title, the main responsibility is to assist passengers in the terminal with general questions. Aviation meteorologist. Aviation meteorologists provide weather information to airline flight dispatchers and pilots. Passenger service agent. Passenger service agents some of the same responsibilities as those in station agent jobs. Ramp planner. An airline ramp planner is responsible for knowing the arrival and departure times for each of the airline's aircraft at that airport. Reservation sales agent. Reservation sales agents provide travel information over the telephone to customers of the airline. Sales representative. Airline sales representative helps generate business for the airlines. Crew scheduler coordinator. Airline crew schedule coordinator are basically responsible for staffing of air crew and ground support to keep flights on schedule. Airline station agent. The most important duty of the station agent is ensuring the overall operations of a given airline at an airport. Airline ticket agent. Ticket agents work at an airline's ticket or baggage counter. Airline flight instructor. An airline flight instructor provides recurrent training for the airline's pilots. Aviation attorney. Aviation attorneys specialize in aviation-related cases in commercial or general aviation. For each type of job profiled in the section, Pilot's Career Guide is an amazing book written by Captain Shekhar Gupta. This book is available on Amazon. Thank you.